Filip Temnyalov presents RILA Monastery, the heart of Bulgaria. Guide, author, director, cinematographer, Filip Temnyalov. RILA Monastery, the oldest in Bulgaria, rises at the foot of RILA, the highest mountain in the Balkans, sacred to the Thracians, Greeks and Slavs in ancient times. The old name Donukas, later RILA, means the mountain of water, and it is no coincidence that there are more than 140 alpine lakes here. The largest rivers in the Balkans are born here and give life to cities like Sofia and Plovdiv. We pass through the villages of Kocherinovo and RILA, the ancient settlements of the Thracians. Today the people here are engaged in animal husbandry and agriculture. They produce vegetables and fruits, herbal honey and red wine. Climbing up the mountain along the picturesque valley of the Rilska River, we pass through the rocky gates of Western RILA, from where in the past it was possible to watch and protect the path to the monastery. The RILA Monastery is the spiritual heart of Bulgaria, which has preserved the Bulgarian culture and identity. The largest monastery in Bulgaria is male, has 5 floors, and looks like a medieval fortress from the outside. Entering the courtyard of the monastery, we are surprised by the contrast and lightness of the black and white arches with the monastic cells. RILA Monastery is over 1,000 years old. The founder and patron of the monastery, Saint Johann of RILA, lived in the 9th and 10th centuries. The first Bulgarian hermit, Saint Johann of RILA, devoted his time to fasting and prayer. The first monastery was built by his followers in the year 927 next to a cave that served as a refuge for the saint. It grew on its present site in the 14th century, when the local ruler Helio Dragoval built a defensive tower, monastic cells and a small church. The construction of the church, Nativity of the Virgin Mary, was completed in 1837 by the first master Pavel Ivanovich from an old family of builders. The temple is a vaulted basilica with 5 domes, 2 chapels and a painted gallery. The frescoes in the cathedral are the work of prominent painters of the 19th century, the famous Zorgraf brothers and masters of the Bansko and Samokov art schools. In the central dome of the gallery we see Almighty Christ, surrounded by 12 symbols of the zodiac, divided into 4 seasons, a projection of the earth on the dome of heaven. Here is the Mother of God with angels and saints. This fresco is a representation of the miraculous icon of the Holy Virgin Osinovitsa, the original of which is found inside the church. In the monastery there are 7 fountains with very tasty drinking water and one very special and beautiful fountain that symbolizes living water. Here we see the struggle between angels and demons for the human soul. Represented here is a white-robed figure ascending to heaven, undergoing trials. In the dome, crowned Jesus Christ. On the facade of the southern chapel, the patron saint of Bulgarians, Johann Rilski, is depicted. The lions here symbolize his spiritual power. His ascension in 946. And here is the grave of the patriarch of Bulgarian teachers, Neophyt Rilski. He founded a cell school in the monastery, wrote textbooks and trained teachers for the whole country. In the 18th and 19th centuries, the monastery was the victim of fires and was rebuilt by the architect famous Alexei Rilits. Today, the monastery covers an area of 8,800 square meters. The monastery has 5 museums, a large library, one of the oldest in the country. On the ground floor is the historical museum with valuable artifacts. Here is also the miraculous icon, the Virgin of Rila. Her image is in almost every Bulgarian house. The monk Raphael sculpted 36 scenes from the life of Christ and 650 miniature statuettes on a cross that bears his name. His work took more than 12 years, and when it was completed, Raphael lost his sight. In 1334, the local feudal lord, Relio, built a 5-story, 25-meter-high defensive tower. Relio Tower is the oldest surviving building in the monastery. At the top of the tower is the Chapel of the Holy Transfiguration with valuable frescoes from the 14th century. A fabulous view opens from the tower. Later, the bell tower with a mechanical clock that strikes every hour was added. The north chapel of the church is dedicated to Saint Nicholas, patron saint of sailors and prototype of Santa Claus. In the dome next to him is the Blessed Virgin with the Christ child. And here is God the Father with Adam and Eve in paradise. The Lord Jesus Christ looks at us with love from this dome, one of the most beautiful images. The Last Judgment scene is impressive. Christ seated on the throne, the Virgin and John the Baptist, under the impartial gaze of Almighty Christ. The fiery river of hell is swallowed up by a two-headed monster along with sinners. You already know that the patron of Bulgaria is Saint Joan of Rila, but it is curious to know who is the patron of the earth. It is written that the devil comes to take the soul of Moses, the prophet of the Jews, and the archangel Michael does not allow it. He had been the patron of the Jews. Since the coming of Christ, the heavenly protector of the earth has been sent Archangel Michael. Therefore, there are no Christian temples without his image. The golden iconostasis, carved in wood by Atanas Telida and Patagarka, completed in 3 years, is the largest in the Balkans. In front of the iconostasis of the church, in a special chest, the imperishable relics of the Rila miracle worker are kept, before which the worship of believers around the world continues to this day. Next to the south chapel of the church is the tomb of the last Bulgarian king Boris III. Here is the miraculous icon with the relics of 32 saints, some of them disciples of Christ, donated in the 12th century by the Byzantine Emperor Emmanuel I Comnenus in memory of his miraculous healing by the relics of Saint Joan of Rila. In the 19th century, 350 monks lived here. Now there are few. There is also a residential part, which in the past housed up to 1,000 people. In the past, the gates of the monastery had armed guards. The small stream that runs past the monastery is Drushliavitsa, a tributary of the Rilska River. The Rila National Park was created to protect nature. We are in the Rila Monastery Forest Reserve. One of these peaks is called the King's Peak. Behind these peaks are the famous seven Rila lakes, also called the Eyes of the Mountain. The water from the nearby Rilska River waterfall can rise 3 times when the snow melts on the peaks. The mountain of waters also gives life to many endemic flowers and herbs, relict plants and trees. There are many wild animals in the reserve. Below the monastery, next to the river, is the cemetery church. The ground floor of the building is a crypt. On the second floor is the Church of the Introduction of the Virgin with frescoes from 1795. On the facade is one of the most beautiful images of Saint Joan of Rila. Because of the good he did to others, because he helped and healed people, he was called an angel on earth and a citizen of heaven. Here are holy warriors, martyrs for the Christian faith and the Mother of God with angels. Entering the Majernitsa, the old kitchen of the monastery, we go through a tunnel and the first thing that catches our attention is a huge oven that produced 5,000 loaves of bread a day for the monastery festivals. Here you can immerse yourself in the atmosphere through the centuries, see a collection of wooden spoons that the monks used to distribute the food portions, they are taller than me. And in the huge cauldrons, in which the lamb sacrifice for St. George's Day was cooked, a group of a dozen tourists can easily be accommodated. The kitchen itself is a unique architectural construction with a 22-meter chimney by the architect Alexey Rylets. Not far from the monastery there is a cave where Saint Joan of Rila lived in the 10th century. There is a belief that when you go through this dark cave, you take away the heavy load of sins, and when you go out into the daylight, you feel that you have been reborn. Spiritual life in the monastery still flourishes, and the imperishable relics of Saint Joan of Rila continue to be a source of consolation, miracles, and heavenly help for those who approach them with faith. Subscribe to the channel, leave likes and comments.